all of us.
خلي في تليفون حد يكلمه التليفون.
فتحي
خليك كده ما حدش اللي واقف ده امال ايه يعني واقف بمنظر
يا عماد ما كانش حد يقدر ده تمام كان مش حد قاعد ورا
شمال اخر شمال بعد ما نبص في اليمين
Laudetur Jesus Christus. This is Vatican Radio. To listeners in Europe, good evening, and to everyone everywhere, welcome. This is Vatican Radio's live English language coverage of the courtesy visit of Pope Francis to his brother, Pope Tawadros. The visit is taking place in the residence complex of the Coptic-Orthodox Pope. Joining you once again in studio, I'm Chris Altieri. And thank you once again to all of you for being with us. And thanks especially to our partners in radio and television for helping to bring us all together. Shalom World TV, Telecare TV, Radio Maria, Salt and Light TV, EWTN TV, Telecare TV, Net TV, Catholic TV, and Radio Maria Philippines. Again, welcome to you all, and thanks to our partners for your help in bringing us all together. The afternoon itinerary of the Holy Father is proceeding somewhat behind schedule. There's really no other way to put it, that due primarily to an extended conversation the Holy Father had upon his arrival behind closed doors and completely out of earshot of the press traveling with the Holy Father or there on the ground to see him arrive. A conversation that lasted a good bit longer than the schedule had allowed. The Holy Father's Ford Focus is now pulling up to the gate at the complex. And Pope Tawadros is there to greet Pope Francis. My goodness, what a magnificent sight to see. Pope Francis and Pope Tawadros. The title Pope being an honorific that goes back into the earliest centuries of the Christian era, a recognition of the special importance of the sees to which the title was attached. The See of Alexandria in Egypt. The See of Pope Tawadros and the See of Rome. Founded by Peter, upon which Francis now sits. Pope Tawadros, greeting, leading the Holy Father in to the venue, greeting, it looked to be the Cardinal President of the Pontifical Council for the Promotion of Christian Unity there, Cardinal Kurt Koch. And now the two popes. Making their way through an alcove and through a doorway. To take them to the a venue in which they will exchange their sets of official remarks. But first, in an antechamber, an exchange in private. And you'll recall, as I said, the Holy Father did remain some time with President Sisi. No word on whether cameras will be or press will be allowed into the a private meeting between Pope Francis and Pope Tawadros. It appeared that some refreshment was being offered to the dignitaries, ecclesiastical and civil, mostly ecclesiastical here, and the address of the Copts, quite distinctive. As is that of the Byzantine and Latin clergy on hand. Movement in the room now, people still taking their places, and again awaiting the public remarks of Pope Francis and Pope Tawadros, who are speaking together in a room adjacent the main conference room that's been prepared and where people are already gathered. It is, again, a brief but extraordinarily intense visit that the Holy Father is making to Egypt over the course of just a little over 24 hours. that began earlier today. We're on the third and final public engagement of the evening. The Holy Father, earlier in the day, following his arrival in the early afternoon, and a brief public welcome ceremony. Then stayed in conversation with Egyptian President Sisi, an extended conversation, but again behind closed doors, and no report that I have seen anyway about what they talked about. The Holy Father then spent a few minutes with the Grand Imam of Al-Azhar University, before addressing the participants in the International Peace Conference underway. Conspicuous by his presence there also was His Holiness, His All Holiness, the Ecumenical Patriarch of Constantinople, Bartholomew. But the two speakers at the event in the afternoon at that press conference, at that conference, were again Pope Francis and the Grand Imam of Al-Azhar, Sheikh Ahmed Al-Tayeb. Following those remarks, the remarks of the Grand Imam and the Holy Father, Pope Francis moved on to a meeting with those in political authority, members of parliament, high officials of state, the diplomatic corps, and leading members of Egypt's civil society. That took place at the enormous hotel complex, the Al-Masa complex inside. At Cairo, of very recent construction, it's a 5-star complex. Uh, 75,000 square feet. A dozen restaurants, 9 reception halls, screening rooms, sporting facilities, and the like. That was the scene of the exchange. Then between the president, again, Abdel Fattah al-Sisi, and Pope Francis. The president speaking first, and then Pope Francis taking the floor, offering his thanks, and again his return to a theme, the praise of the nobility and antiquity of Egypt, and the unique mission that the nation has in the region. In the present day, a mission tied somehow to its mission in the broader history of God's saving action in the world. The remarks of the Holy Father concluded with a powerful exhortation, encouragement offered especially to the Christians of Egypt, those present in the hall where the encounter was taking place, and those throughout the country, whom the Holy Father greeted as my Christian sons and daughters and brothers and sisters who live in this country, Egypt, Coptic Orthodox, Greek Byzantines, Armenian Orthodox, Protestants, and Catholics. And he prayed that Saint Mark, the evangelizer of the land of Egypt, might watch over them all and help all of us to build and achieve, and help them especially to build and achieve the unity so greatly desired by our Lord. A unity that is like the gift of peace itself, again a gift of God, but also the work of man. Two things that are not mutually exclusive. And the work of Christian unity is essentially, for Pope Francis, a work of witness. There's movement now on the raised dais in this venue that has been prepared. There brief signs of the scene of the terror bombing in December of 2016. It was also briefly visible there to those of you who are joining us. Over the television airwaves. there is to be. Following the exchange of remarks, the public remarks and the exchange of gifts, a brief procession and a moment of prayer in that a chapel dedicated to St. Peter that was the scene of that attack that claimed so many victims. The chapel, Albutrosia. That is the chapel dedicated to St. Peter. For a moment of ecumenical prayer in the presence of the heads of other Christian confessions as well, those present at the encounter and in Egypt. On Palm Sunday of this year, a pair of attacks claimed scores of victims once again in Egypt. In Tanta and Alexandria, Tanta north of Cairo. And in Alexandria proper. The attack in Alexandria believed to have been after, aimed at Pope Tawadros himself. And again, for those of you just joining us, this is Vatican Radio's live English language coverage of the afternoon events on this first afternoon of Pope Francis' visit to Egypt. A brief, but again, very intense visit to the country. Really in and around the city of Cairo. Lasting just over 24 hours. The visit unfolding quite serenely. Extraordinary security measures have been taken. As we were just saying, the Christian community in Egypt has been targeted with a series of deadly attacks in recent months, including just before Easter on Palm Sunday, a pair of deadly attacks. His Holiness Pope Tawadros himself is a figure of enormous interest. He's a fascinating character who has lived an extraordinarily interesting life. He studied pharmacy at the University of Alexandria. He was born in 1952 and ordained only in 1989. He's the 118th Pope of the Coptic Orthodox Church, the Patriarch of Alexandria of Egypt and all Africa, and of the Holy See of St. Mark. He was elected in 2012, in November of that month. Cardinal Koch was present to represent the Holy See and the Holy Father on that occasion. Cardinal Koch is the president of the Pontifical Council for the Promotion of Christian Unity. I mentioned him earlier when he and His Holiness Pope Tawadros exchanged greetings on the way in. But again, after earning his degree in pharmacy, he went, the man who became Pope Tawadros, it was Wagi Sobi Baki Soliman, born to the world, and he went to work for the World Health Organization. And he began his studies in theology and concluded them in 1983, but then after that worked as a manager in a pharmaceutical company before entering the monastery of Saint Bishoy. That was in 1986, and he took his monastic vows and then his priestly vows a year after that. He was ordained a bishop in 1997, and that was when he took the name Tawadros. He's been a prolific author. He has a special concern and solicitude for the pastoral care of young people. And we're very much looking forward to hearing from His Holiness. This evening, Pope Francis and Pope Tawadros have reached their places, having come out of their antechamber where they were holding their private conversations. Communicating, it seems now, between themselves, but through the interpreter. And we await the official opening and unfolding of the public part of this visit.
Christos Anisti, Al-Masih Qam, Akhuna Al-Habib, Sahib Al-Qadasa, Al-Baba Francis, Bism A'da Al-Majma' Al-Muqaddas, Wa Kull Al-Hayat Al-Kanasiyya, نرحب بقداستكم في بلدنا مصر بلد التاريخ والحضارة حيث يلتقي الغرب بالشرق.
Our beloved brother, His Holiness Pope Francis, Christ is risen, Christ is truly risen.
ليشرب كل المصريين منه الوسطية والاعتدال. أرحب بكم في مصر ملجأ العائلة المقدسة.
Greetings now on behalf of the members of the Holy Synod and of all the church organizations present in Egypt. Welcome to our country, the country, again, of history and civilization, where West meets with East from the dawn of history, and where the Nile has always run, and from which Egyptians have learned to draw.
فأنتم رمز من رموز السلام في عالم صاخب بالصراعات والحروب عالم يتوق لجهود مخلصة في نشر السلام والمحبة ونبذ العمر.
Egypt, which was the refuge of the Holy Family for several years, when they traveled from east to west blessing the earth and the people. Welcome, Holy Father, to the Orthodox Coptic Church, the cradle of monastic life, the mother of martyrs, the inspiration of the Alexandrian school. Lighthouse of theology and history.
إذ وجدنا رجلا مملوءا بروح الله ولمسنا والوفد المرافق.
Your presence is a new step on the way of love and fraternity among peoples. You are, Holy Father, a symbol of your holiness, a symbol of peace in a world tormented by conflicts and wars. Welcome, Holiness, to our land, our beloved land, which too often pays innocent blood, offering the flower of its youth, its most beautiful treasures, that Egypt might remain a land of peace for everyone. Welcome to your holiness, the Pope of Peace, to the land of peace. Today, welcoming you to this patriarchal see, let us recall with sentiments of love and joy the benevolence and generosity with which you welcomed us to the Vatican 4 years ago. There we met a man filled with the Holy Spirit, and together with the delegation with whom we traveled, we took sincere efforts to strengthen the relationship between the two ancient apostolic sees, one of St. Peter and one of St. Mark. Something deserving of every appreciation and esteem. The choice of May 10th, 2013, as the day for our visit to the Vatican was not random, but was chosen to remind us of the visit of Pope Shenouda to Pope Paul VI on that same day in 1973. An annual tradition it became to celebrate then the Day of Fraternal Love among the Orthodox Church and the Catholic Church, in which we pray together and exchange and share the faith and the food of love. A visit, therefore, with intense spiritual meaning today, because it is close to the time of Easter, and our dialogue recalls the story of the two disciples on the way to Emmaus, about whom Scripture says, as they talked and discussed together, Jesus came to them and walked with them.
ولا يجوز لنا إغفال دور الآباء الدومينيكان في البحث العلمي والحوار بين الشرق والغرب من خلال معهدهم ودائرهم العامر بالقاهرة.
So this dialogue between the Eastern churches with the Catholic Church, which the official dialogue of the groups of churches to which His Holiness is referring is marking its 15th anniversary in an atmosphere in which all members of the churches affirm the conviction of the importance of the Lord's words. From this, all will know that you are my disciples, that you will have love for each other. Unity in today's world is the clearest and most fundamental witness to Christ that we can offer the world. Therefore, Holiness, we wait for the day when we will break bread together on the sacred altar, the day when all the bells of the churches will sound together to celebrate the birth of the Savior or His resurrection. We take this blessed occasion to address our thanks to the Catholic Church for what it did in the field of culture. No one can deny the generous commitment of the Christian brothers, the Jesuits, the Sisters of the Sacred Heart, through their contributions to educational revival in Egypt. These organizations, particularly, and these orders and congregations, particularly present in Egypt. Nor can one neglect the role of the Dominican Fathers in scientific research and in the dialogue between East and West through their institute and their monastery in Cairo and other Catholic religious orders in Egypt that have brought modern experiences in terms of content and methodology, which contribute to the improvement of all members of society, regardless of their religion and ethnicity. Thanks also to the Catholic Church on behalf of the many Egyptian Coptic Catholics who have been able to pray and celebrate in full joy the festivities on Catholic altars.
على رأسها دعوة فخامة الرئيس عبد الفتاح السيسي التي مثلت دعوة عموم المصريين جميعا هي أبلغ رسالة للعالم كله لكي يعي ويرى مصر كنموذج رائد في فهم الآخر واحترامه.
Pope Francis, we would still like to express our appreciation for your beloved person, for your role on the world stage, which has become evident since the beginning of your mandate, since you chose the name of Saint Francis of Assisi, a name that brought with it very high hopes that were translated into actuality with the publication of texts such as Evangelii Gaudium and Laudato Si.
في الأشهر القليلة الماضية حين امتدت يد الإرهاب الآسمة لتقتل أبرياء يصلون في غير خوف في معية مخلصهم فيطالهم ما دبر بليل وخسة ليترك وطننا بأسره كليم وليتشح بحداد الحزن بلد بأكمله ولأننا في حفظ الله فإن يده الحانية تمتد دائما لتمسح على فجيعتنا ولتربط على قلوبنا ولتمنح أرواحنا سكينة بمشاهد معزية وصادقة.
We do not hide, Holiness, that in recent months our church and our country have experienced dramatic and painful experiences when the guilty hand of terrorism took up arms to kill innocent people, people who prayed without fear in the company of their Savior. Our homeland, therefore, has wounds that are still open and is pervaded by sadness. We are protected by God. His benevolent hand is always stretched to relieve our misfortune and attenuate our pain, caressing our hearts, giving serenity to our souls with sincere demonstrations of consolation and of comfort. In these trying times, the true value of the Egyptian people united in sorrow is revealed, the true worth. Announcing, proclaiming to the whole world that our misfortune and sorrow are those of a united people and nation. Criminal minds shall never succeed in breaking or weakening the hearts of the people whose valor is truly an example for all generations. A country of peace and security, an oasis where civilizations meet by declaring that under the heaven of Egypt, all can live in peace until the end of time. So thank you once again for this visit, and we hope it will be followed by others in the future. Yeah. Will not be last, the last of its kind. Last but not least, we want to promise to you, Holy Father, confirm for you that you have been and always will be in our daily prayers, present in our daily prayers. You are imprinted onto our heart. Your Holiness, Pope of Peace, welcome to the land of peace.
E quest'anno abbiamo avuto la grazia di celebrare nello stesso giorno. Abbiamo così proclamato all'unisono l'annuncio della risurrezione, rivivendo in un certo senso l'esperienza dei primi discepoli, che in quel giorno insieme gioirono al vedere il Signore. Questa gioia pasquale...
Your Holiness, dear brother... The Lord is risen. He is truly risen. Only a short time has passed since the great solemnity of Easter, the heart of the Christian life, which we were blessed this year to celebrate on the same day. We thus joined in proclaiming the Easter message and, in a sense, relived the experience of the first disciples who together rejoiced when they saw the Lord that day. This paschal joy is today made all the more precious by the gift of our joining to worship the risen one in prayer and by our renewed exchange in his name of the holy kiss and embrace of peace. For this I am deeply grateful. In coming here as a pilgrim, I was sure of receiving the blessing of a brother who awaited me. I have eagerly looked forward to this new meeting, for I vividly recall the visit Your Holiness made to Rome shortly after my election, on May 10, 2013, that date which has happily become the occasion for celebrating an annual day of friendship, as he mentioned, between Copts and Catholics. As we joyfully progress on our ecumenical journey, I wish particularly to recall that milestone in relations between the sees of Peter and Mark, which is the common declaration signed by our predecessors more than 40 years ago on May 10, 1973. After centuries of difficult history marked by increasing theological differences nourished and widened by non-theological factors and growing mistrust, we were able that day, with God's help, to acknowledge together that Christ is perfect God with respect to his divinity and perfect man with respect to his humanity.
Ma non meno importanti e attuali sono le parole immediatamente precedenti.
Yet equally important and timely are the words that immediately precede this statement, in which we acknowledge Jesus Christ as our Lord and God and Savior and King. With these words, the See of Mark and the See of Peter proclaimed the Lordship of Jesus. Together we confessed that we belong to Jesus and that he is our all.
Non possiamo più pensare di andare avanti ciascuno per la sua strada, perché tradiremmo la sua volontà. Che i suoi siano
What is more, we realize that because we belong to Him, we can no longer think that each can go his own way, for that would betray His will, that His disciples all be one so that the world may believe. In the sight of God, who wishes us to be perfectly one, it is no longer possible to take refuge behind the pretext of differing interpretations, much less of those centuries of history and traditions that estranged us one from the other.
Rappresenta già una realtà profonda e fondamentale.
In the words of His Holiness Pope St. John Paul II, there is no time to lose in this regard. Our communion in the one Lord Jesus Christ, in the one Holy Spirit, and in one baptism already represents a deep and fundamental reality. Consequently, not only is there an ecumenism of gestures, words, and commitment, but an already effective communion that grows daily in living relation with the Lord Jesus. Is rooted in the faith we profess and is truly grounded on our baptism and our being made a new creation in Him. In a word, there is one Lord, one faith, one baptism. Hence, we constantly set out anew in order to hasten that eagerly awaited day when we will be in full and visible communion around the altar of the Lord. In this exciting journey, which, like life itself, is not always easy and straightforward, but on which the Lord exhorts us to persevere, we are not alone. Un'immagine vivente della Gerusalemme di lassù. Tra costoro certamente oggi si rallegrano in modo particolare. We are accompanied by a great host of saints and martyrs who, already fully one, impel us here below to be a living image of the Jerusalem above. Among them, surely Peter and Mark in particular rejoice in our encounter today. Great is the bond uniting them. We need only think of the fact that St. Mark put at the heart of his gospel Peter's profession of faith. You are the Christ. It was the answer to Jesus' ever urgent question, but who do you say that I am? Today, too, many people cannot answer this question. There are even few people who can raise it, and above all, few who can answer it with the joy of knowing Jesus. That same joy with which we have the grace of confessing Him together.
Prima di tutto, nel modo che ha la fede è proprio, vivendola, perché la presenza di Gesù.
Together, then, we are called to bear witness to Him, to carry our faith to the world, especially in the way it is meant to be carried, to be brought, by living it so that Jesus' presence can be communicated with life and speak the language of gratuitous and concrete love. As Coptic-Orthodox and Catholics, we can always join in speaking this common language of charity. Before undertaking a charitable work, we would do well to ask if we can do it together with our brothers and sisters who share our faith in Jesus. Thus, by building communion in the concreteness of a daily lived witness, the Spirit will surely open providential and unexpected paths to unity.
Nei confronti della Chiesa Copta Cattolica, una vicinanza di cui sono tanto grato e che ha trovato lodevole espressione nel Consiglio Nazionale delle Chiese Cristiane, al quale ha dato vita perché i credenti in Gesù possano operare sempre più insieme a beneficio dell'intera società egiziana.
It is with this constructive apostolic spirit that Your Holiness continues to show a genuine and fraternal attention for the Coptic Catholic Church. I am most grateful for this closeness, which has found praiseworthy expression in the National Council of Christian Churches, which you have established so that believers in Jesus can work together more closely for the benefit of Egyptian society as a whole. I also greatly appreciated the generous hospitality offered to the 13th meeting of the International Joint Commission for Theological Dialogue between the Catholic Church and the Oriental Orthodox Churches, which took place here last year at your invitation. It is a promising sign that the following meeting took place this year in Rome, as if to bespeak a particular continuity between the sees of Mark and Peter. In the sacred scriptures, Peter seems in some way to reciprocate the affection of Mark by calling him my son. But the evangelist and his apostolic activity are also fraternally associated with Saint Paul, who, before dying a martyr in Rome, mentions Mark's great usefulness in his ministry and speaks of him frequently.
La maturazione del nostro cammino ecumenico è sostenuta.
Fraternal charity and communion in mission. These are the messages that the Word of God and our own origins have bequeathed to us. They are the evangelical seeds that we rejoice to water together and with God's help to make grow. The deepening progress of our ecumenical journey is also sustained in mysterious and quite relevant way by a genuine ecumenism of blood. Saint John tells us that Jesus came with water and blood. Whoever believes in him thus overcomes the world. With water and blood. By living a new life in our common baptism, a life of love always and for all, even at the cost of the sacrifice of one's life. How many martyrs in this land from the first centuries of Christianity have lived their faith heroically to the end, shedding their blood rather than denying the Lord, and yielding to the enticements of evil, or merely to the temptation of repaying evil with evil. The venerable martyrology of the Coptic Church bears eloquent witness to this. Even in recent days, tragically, the innocent blood of defenseless Christians was cruelly shed. Their innocent blood unites us. Most dear brother, just as the heavenly Jerusalem is one, so too is our martyrology. Your sufferings are also our sufferings. Strengthened by this witness, let us strive to oppose violence by preaching and sowing goodness, fostering concord and preserving unity, praying that all these sacrifices may open the way to a future of full communion between us and of peace for all.
Appena terminate le antiche persecuzioni, sorse una forma nuova di vita che, donata al Signore, nulla tratteneva per sé.
The impressive history of holiness of this land is distinguished not only by the sacrifice of the martyrs. No sooner had the ancient persecutions ended than a new and selfless form of life arose as a gift of the Lord. Monasticism originated in the desert. Thus, the great signs that God had once worked in Egypt and at the Red Sea were followed by the miracle of a new life that made the desert blossom with sanctity.
trovò refugio.
With veneration for this shared patrimony, I have come as a pilgrim to this land that the Lord himself loves to visit. For here in his glory he came down upon Mount Sinai, and here in his humility he found refuge as a child.
In questo cammino ci prenda per mano. Colei che qui ha accompagnato.
Your Holiness, dearest brother, may the same Lord today grant us to set out together as pilgrims of communion and messengers of peace. On this journey, may the Virgin Mary take us by the hand. She who brought Jesus here and whom the great Egyptian theological tradition has from of old acclaimed as Theotokos, the Mother of God. In this title, humanity and divinity are joined, for in his mother God became forever man. May the Blessed Virgin, who constantly leads us to Jesus, the perfect symphony of divine and human, bring yet once more a bit of heaven to our earth. And for those of you just joining us, this is Vatican Radio's live English language coverage of the third and final event of the first afternoon of the Holy Father's visit to Egypt, a meeting, a courtesy call. It was billed, but it was really very much more than that, if I may say, between Pope Francis and Pope Tawadros. At the Coptic Pope's residence in Cairo. And now, we see the Holy Father, Pope Francis, and His Holiness sitting and signing a document. Several different copies of which are being assigned at the moment. We've gone off mic and cannot hear what is being said, if anything, between the signatures, a shaking of hands, a common declaration. Being signed by Pope Tawadros and Pope Francis. And now an exchange of gifts. this a cross in the Coptic style, being offered in gift. By Pope Tawadros to Pope Francis. And a triptych as well. For a corner table or shrine. We understand. That the gifts being presented by Pope Francis to His Holiness Pope Tawadros, the gift is an icon of Our Lady, Mother of God, of tenderness. Apologies for disappearing there for a second, ladies and gentlemen who were tuning in. I just had confirmation of the common declaration that the Holy Father, Pope Francis, and the Pope of Alexandria, His Holiness Pope Tawadros, had signed. It is indeed a common declaration dealing with common baptism, the operative part of which reads, in obedience to the work of the Holy Spirit who sanctifies the Church, keeps her throughout the ages, and leads her to full unity, the unity for which Jesus Christ prayed. Today, we, Pope Francis and Pope Tawadros II, in order to please the heart of the Lord Jesus, as well as that of our sons and daughters in the faith, mutually declare that we will not repeat the baptism that had been administered in either of our churches for any person who wishes to join the other. This we confess in obedience to the Holy Scriptures and the faith of the three ecumenical councils assembled in Nicaea, Constantinople, and Ephesus. We ask God our Father to guide us in the times and by the means that the Holy Spirit will choose to full unity in the mystical body of Christ. So mutual recognition of baptism. An official mutual recognition of baptism on the part of the Coptic Orthodox Church and the Catholic Church. The operative part of the joint declaration, the common declaration, signed this evening in Cairo, at the residence of His Holiness Pope Tawadros II. You see, a second gift I did not describe, the statue of St. Francis of Assisi. Those of you joining us on the television airwaves were able to see very briefly a shot of that statue. And the greetings on the delegations now being greeted, the respective delegations. And all are making their way. Now, from the hall of the complex where Pope Francis and Pope Tawadros met and addressed each other and really the entire nation of Egypt, all the Christians of various confessions, and indeed the whole world offering a witness of faith. One faith, one Lord, one baptism. The ecumenism of blood. Was indeed a major focus. Of the remarks of both Pope Francis and Pope Tawadros. The desire to take concrete steps to give fuller expression to our unity. Both leaders expressing enormous confidence that the Lord will show the way. And that it is our part to discern it. And outside, where night has fallen in Cairo, the exchanges of greetings and pleasantries continue. And two columns of acolytes stand ready to proceed, if we have understood, to the chapel of St. Peter inside the complex, which was the scene of the terrible attack in December of 2016. at the attack, at the December attack. Claiming victims. Just a few. A very short distance from the offices of His Holiness Pope Tawadros. The attack claimed some 25 lives. And was one that again is believed to have targeted His Holiness Pope Tawadros personally. Another such attack that did target, it is also believed, Pope Tawadros was one of the two attacks on Christians that took place on Palm Sunday of this year. Now, for those of you just joining us, this is Vatican Radio's live English language coverage of the third and final public event of the day for the Holy Father, who is in Egypt on a brief but intense visit to the country. Preparing now, it seems, to the company arrayed and prepared for the procession. The greetings of the various delegations having come to an end. These greetings, more of the unofficial pleasantry and variety. Those that continue. As the Al-Butrusiya Chapel begins to fill. Patriarch Bartholomew, His All Holiness, the Ecumenical Patriarch of Constantinople, who is in Cairo for the Peace Conference, is one on hand. Thank you. and the a receiving line, actually, that seemed to have been ended, simply interrupted and began again on the other side as the participants, the dignitaries, both ecclesiastical and civil, but mostly ecclesiastical, as we've seen, continue to make their way into the chapel of St. Peter. The events of the afternoon and now stretching into the evening are running a bit behind schedule. The Holy Father had a longer than anticipated conversation with Egypt's president, Abdel Fattah al-Sisi, at the airport. Upon his arrival, and has been taking his time seeing people, greeting people, making sure that his presence is not rushed and perfunctory, but genuine. Amidst all of the requirements of protocols and protocol and security. Now the procession has begun.
Thank you.
For those of you just joining us, this is Vatican Radio's live English language coverage. Now, of the ecumenical prayer being celebrated in the chapel of St. Peter, which was the scene of an attack that was an attempt, authorities understood. Certainly on the complex, within the complex of the residence complex of the Patriarch of Alexandria of the Copts, His Holiness Pope Tawadros. Hard by his office, 25 people at least were killed in that attack in December of 2016. And it is a sight to see. The leadership of Christian confessions in Egypt and throughout the region gathered around the three figures, Pope Tawadros seated center, to his left, His All-Holiness, the Ecumenical Patriarch of Constantinople, and to his right, Pope Francis, the Pope of Rome.
Oh.
Gesù salì sulla montagna e messosi a sedere, gli si avvicinarono i suoi discepoli. Prendendo allora la parola,
Pope Francis, now taking.
Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they that mourn, for they shall be comforted.
Μακάρι η πτωχή το πνεύματι, ότι αυτόν εστίν η βασιλεία των ουρανών. Μακάρι οι πεθούντες, ότι αυτοί παρακληθήσονται. Αμήν.
طوبى للودعاء لأنهم يرثون الأرض. طوبى للجياع والعطاش إلى البر لأنهم يشبعون.
طوبى للرحماء لأنهم يرحمون. طوبى لأنقياء القلب لأنهم يعاينون الله.
طوبى لصانعي السلام لأنهم أبناء الله يدعون. طوبى للمطرودين من أجل البر لأن لهم ملكوت السماوات.
طوبى لكم إذا عيروكم واضطردوكم وقالوا عليكم كل كلمة شريرة من أجل كاذبين. افرحوا وتهللوا لأن أجركم عظيم في السماوات فإنهم هكذا طردوا الأنبياء الذين قبلكم.
قبلوا بعضكم بعضا بقبلة مقدسة يا رب ارحم يا رب ارحم يا رب ارحم.
This moment of ecumenical prayer, beginning with the Holy Father leading them in the reading of the fifth chapter of the Gospel according to St. Matthew, verses 1 to 12.
A mi hermano, el Papa Tawadros II, que bendigas a todos mis hermanos obispos que estamos aquí. Que bendigas a todos mis hermanos cristianos y que nos lleves por el camino de la caridad y del trabajar juntos hacia la mesa de la Eucaristía. Amén.
أيها المسيح القائم.
Pope Francis praying first. That God bless his dear brother, Pope Tawadros, and all his brother bishops present, and admit us all to the Eucharistic table together as soon
من أجل هذه النعمة الجزيلة التي أعطيتها لنا.
As his provident will permits it.
في زيارة أخينا الحبيب قداسة البابا فرانسيس وكل الأباء.
A prayer of thanksgiving for the great grace.
نشكرك يا رب يا من تعطينا هذه المحبة.
That God has bestowed on all of us today, especially the visit of our beloved brother Francis. Bless us all, and let us pray for all those who suffer, who
Bless
us all, Lord, through the martyrs who have given even their very bodily selves in the service of your church here, and by the intercession of our mother, of Saint Peter, Saint Mark. As we wait your glorious return.
Ya Rabbur Ham, Ya Rabbur Raham. المسيح ابن الله اسمعنا وارحمنا تقدموا على هذا الرأس قفوا برعدة وإلى الشرق انظروا أبانا الذي في السماوات يتقدس اسمك ليأتي ملكوتك وتكن مشيئتك كذلك على الأرض خبزنا الذي أعطينا اليوم واغفر لنا ذنوبنا كما نغفر نحن أيضا للمذنبين.
The Lord's Prayer.
ولا تدخلنا في تجربة لكن نجنا من الشرير بالمسيح يسوع ربنا أن لك الملك والقوة والمجد إلى الأبد أمين.
من فضلكم نبقى في أماكننا لغاية الموكب ما يخرج ومعهم الكرة دانيالا عشان يضيئوا الشموع في الخارج وإحنا نبقى في الأماكن لغاية الموكب ما يخرج نبقى في أماكننا.
And with this praying of the Lord's Prayer, the Our Father, this ecumenical prayer service is in its essence concluded. There is however the placement a final a gesture of the day to which we're very happy to be a privy here the lighting of a candle and the placement of a floral wreath at the shrine that has been erected inside the chapel space in memory of the victims of the attack here in December of last year. Each of the leaders placing a flower And now all paused in a moment of prayerful recollection. For those of you just joining us, this is Vatican Radio's live English language coverage of the Ecumenical Prayer Service, the third and final, or the final portion of the third and final event of the day, this first day of Pope Francis's visit to Cairo. End of the prayer service saw a brief trip across the complex out of the St. Peter's Chapel to the place and scene of an attack inside the chapel complex itself. The scene of an attack claimed nearly 30 lives. In December of 2016, inside the complex itself. The ecumenical leaders, including Pope Francis and Pope Tawadros, placing flowers and lighting a candle before the memorial. And now Pope Tawadros is leading Pope Francis out into what is already evening. Full dark has fallen. Night has fallen. Motorcade of Pope Francis prepared to depart. You can imagine the extraordinary security measures being taken on the occasion of this visit, but Pope Francis has not been deterred. The security measures, the protocol, the requirements of protocol, quite apart from the security measures, have not kept the Holy Father from being present and living this experience in the way that he always does enjoy to do and is always anxious to do, which is with the pace and the measure of an engaged humanity. And now we're told that indeed the departure is imminent, and so our time this evening is concluded, but for this and for all of the events of the Holy Father's brief again but intense visit starting again tomorrow morning, you can find us here, and we will be with you. from me, Chris Altieri, and from all of us, thank you for being with us this evening. Laudetur Jesus Christus.
Shabbat.